So we were asked this great question about what is the status of the McMaster Nuclear Reactor. So we thought we'd take you inside and show you. This is my graduate student, Monique. Mo uses the reactor for her research, and she's also a tour guide who takes people through. So Mo, why don't you take us in?
Alrighty.
So welcome to the Mac Nuclear Reactor. You are in the main area beside the pool. The reactor core is actually just down below us, under a lot of water, so we are shielded from the radiation. One of the things that the Mac reactor does is it produces medical isotopes. We are one of the world's largest supplier of radioisotopes for the treatment of prostate cancer. And so several hundred men a week are treated for cancer from isotopes that come from here at Mac. So we use the reactor for teaching. And in fact, I have taught radiation and radioisotope methodology classes where we bring undergraduate and graduate students in here at least once a week, and they actually do experiments using the core. And one of the great things about McMaster is because we have this facility, our undergraduate and graduate experience is quite unique in Canada. When people graduate, they've already been in a nuclear facility and they're quite experienced. So that makes them more ready for the job market. So there are a lot of alumni out there who experience this facility, and I hope if they're looking at it and seeing the blue glow, it is giving them a nostalgic feeling for their time at Mac. So inside the Mac reactor, we have what's called a hot cell, which is a very radioactive source. It's 10,000 curies of cobalt-60, and it allows us to irradiate things to high intensity. So the source is in behind this very thick lead glass, and components can be put inside and irradiated. And they do things like testing satellite components and sterilizing medical equipment. They've even sterilized dirt.
So what we're doing right now is we're actually testing a special type of detector that is used for space satellites. And the idea here is to make sure, find out if that detector will survive the radiation, the trip there, and still operate at its, well, normal parameters. So if it does work after all the dose that we're deposited right now, then we'll be able to find out if we can actually use it on the next mission, or we'll have to look for something else. So a unique facility such as this allows us to answer a question of, will it work in space after a few years or a few months of operation? So there you go.
So one of the really cool facilities we have here at the McMaster Nuclear Reactor is the Neutron Radiography facility, which is down below me here. And what we do with neutron radiography is it's very similar to X-radiography, where you take X-rays of things. But X-rays are very good at looking at things like metal or bones. And we use neutrons because they allow us to discriminate different things than we can do with X-rays. And one of the things we do here at Mac is there is a company called NRAY, and they do neutron radiographs of these turbine blades that are from commercial aircraft. And what they're looking for are defects in the turbine blades that would mean that they could crack when they get hot in the engine. So it allows them to screen their turbine blades, and it means that the Mac nuclear reactor helps make for safer aircraft. One of the things we're really excited about in the nuclear facilities is, just outside the window here, is the extension that has been built that's going to house the new small angle neutron scattering facility that has been put together by a grant that was submitted by Professor Bruce Galland from Physics and Astronomy. And the intention of that facility is to study, do material science research, and especially to study soft matter and biological materials. And by finding new materials, it will allow us to develop new technologies, both for technology, but also for healthcare applications. So a few years from now, there's going to be whole new frontiers of research going on in that building. Because we've been in a nuclear facility, we have to check that we haven't picked up any contamination as we on our tour through. So we actually get checked twice. The first time we get checked is just as we leave the facility on this hand and foot monitor. Now we have to get checked a second time to make sure that as we came out the nuclear facility, we didn't pick up any contamination. And we do this full body monitor check. So I hope you enjoyed our little virtual tour of the Mac nuclear reactor. If you want a real tour, you can have a tour. The facility tours a couple of thousand people through a year. So you can go to the McMaster Nuclear Reactor website and you will find a space where you can request a tour. And we hope to see you in person. So thanks, bye-bye.